Hi, I'm a banana, and today we're going to learn about x and y intercepts. Now, x intercepts are any points that end up on the x axis. Y intercepts are any points that end up on the y axis. So let's actually find the coordinates of each of these green points, the x intercepts. This one right here, let's see, negative 1, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4. This is negative 4, 0. This point right here is 2, 0. 3, 4. This point here is 5, 0. And this last point is 7, 0. Now, other than all being x-intercepts, do you notice anything else they all have in common? You may notice that all of them have 0 as the y-coordinate. Now, let's look at the y-intercepts, these red dots. This one right here has the coordinates 0, negative 1. This one down here, let's see, negative 2, negative 3, negative 4, negative 5. So 0, negative 5. Up here, 0, 4, and 0, 6. You may notice all the y-intercepts have zeros as their x-coordinate. And that's going to be helpful in finding x and y intercepts when we don't have a graph to work with. Let's look at that. Here we have to find the x and y intercepts of the line 3x minus 4y equals 12. So there's going to be a line that crosses the x and y axis. And our job is to figure out exactly where does it cross. In other words, what is the x intercept? What is the y intercept? Now, in order to be an x-intercept, the y-coordinate has to be 0. So what we can do here is actually plug in a 0 for y and solve for x. Let's try that. So 3x minus 4, and instead of writing y, I'm going to put a 0 there, equals 12. So 4 times 0 is just 0, so we end up with 3x equals 12, and x equals 4. That means our x-intercept is at 4, 0. Now let's find the y-intercept. To find the y-intercept, we're going to plug in a 0 for x. So we have 3 times 0 minus 4y equals 12. And we end up with negative 4y equals 12. Divide both sides by negative 4. And we get y equals negative 3. So our y-intercept is at zero, negative 3. Now using our x-intercept and our y-intercept, we can actually quickly graph this line. We just need to graph the point 4, 0 and the point 0, negative 3. So 4, 0, our x-intercept is right here. And 0, negative 3, our y-intercept is right here. All we have to do is connect those points. And there's a graph of our line. Now, if you're used to doing xy tables, there's one more way we can calculate the x and y intercepts. When you make an xy table, you simply need to find out what's the value of x when y equals 0. That will tell you the x intercept. And what's the value of y when x equals 0. That will tell you the x intercept, or the y intercept, sorry. All right, good luck.